This last example is really interesting. Let's say you're trying to build customer profiles by asking them survey questions about how much they enjoy various things, maybe different foods or different movies, and you rate them on a scale from, I don't know, negative 10 to positive 10, hate it versus they love it. And you might ask them a bunch of different questions about different things, whether they like it or don't like it. Then what you do is you take all of that data and build up a preference space where each product that you're asking a question about gives you a coordinate axis. And the coordinates, P1, P2, P3, up through PN, are for these N different products. Okay, that can be a little abstract sounding, a little hard to see what the total product preference space looks like, this n-dimensional space. Let's consider a simple example where you just have three products. So you ask people about three different items, and they rank each one on a scale from hate it to love it. But you do this for lots and lots of different customers, so you get this giant point cloud, this collection of points in this three-dimensional space in this case. And then what you want to do is analyze those points and try to group them together. Say, oh, look, here's a group of customers that all, they hate both these products. And then here's another group of customers that love both these products. But then you've got another group of customers for which they hate the one and love the other. And then how does this interact with the other products that you've asked about? In the end, what you want to do is partition up this data set into groups, into clusters, so that you can better characterize the customers. And in general, and this is happening in an N-dimensional space.